Hello, I'm Tim. I'm the PM for the package stage. And today I was hoping to do a quick speed run of a feature for the dependency proxy that's available now on GitLab.com and will be included in the 14.2 release. So right now you can use the dependency proxy to proxy and cache images from Docker Hub to help you reduce your reliance on external dependencies. You can avoid Docker Hub rate limits and also speed up your builds. Prior to this issue being completed, you can authenticate using some predefined environment variables that we have or a personal access token. But having talked to many of you in the community and our customers, we heard that it's really important to be able to use deploy tokens for this feature as well. So this issue proposed and added support for group deploy tokens for authentication with the dependency proxy. So the first thing that I wanted to do is just head over to the documentation, and you could see here that you can authenticate with the dependency proxy, and now we see that a group deploy token with the scope set to read registry or write registry will work. So let's see. I have this project that I've created. It's in a subgroup here, and I have my GitLab pipeline definition file, and you could see here that I'm basically running Docker login and I'm signing in with a username. And then here I have my token username and my token password. And then I'm running Docker pull with this really long URL. Okay, so let's break that down into pieces. The first step is going to be to create the deploy token. So for that, what I actually did was go into my subgroup. I'm gonna open that in another tab. And this just has a few projects in here for the dependency proxy that I have worked on. And then if I go to settings and to repository, I can see here that the option to create deploy tokens, I can expand this. And once you're here, you can name it whatever you want. You can assign an expiration date. You can enter a username if you wanted to. But for the dependency proxy, what's important is that you give access to both read and write registry. Once you do that, once you hit submit, it will create a token and it'll populate values here. And then what I did after that was go and create some project specific environment variables called token username and token password in my project. So for that, I'm gonna go to settings and then to CICD, I'm gonna open that in a new tab. And then here we see variables. So we can expand this as well. You could see here that I have these, my username and password. I'm obviously not gonna reveal the values. So that's how I'm logging in. So this line here, I'm basically saying Docker login, use my deploy token, username and password. So where did I get this URL from for the dependency proxy? Well, if I go back to that group, so here I'm in that, I'll just open it so we can see. I'm in my subgroup here. And if I navigate to, just expand it to packages and registries, I could see the dependency proxy. And here I could see the dependency proxy URL. Now, one important thing, and actually a fix that's coming out of this demo, is you don't want to include the HTTPS here. You just want to include from GitLab forward. So we're actually working on an MR at this moment that will change this to say dependency proxy, and then it won't include the HTTPS. Okay. So go back to my YAML file. I see that that's working, and I will now just go to edit this. Just add one thing. Oops. Changes. Terrible commit message. Let's go over to the pipeline. quickly pause while this runs. Should just take a second. Okay, yeah, so it finished and I could see here that Docker login was successful. And then I could see that my latest Nginx image was pulled properly. So yeah, I was able to just using a group deploy token, proxy and cache an image using without a problem using GitLab CI. Okay, and if you have any questions, feel free to add a comment to the issue and let us know how you're enjoying the feature. Thank you, everyone.